So it's the time of year when you look for a new calendar for next year, or you get calendars to give as holiday gifts. And you can create your own using the Photos app on your Mac. It's pretty easy to do, and of course it's special because you get to use your own photos for it. And it's really not that expensive. So let's look at how to do it. So I'm going to start here with an album. I'm already in an album called Vacation. So I have all these photos here. Starting with an album means that I'll have a bunch of photos that it can automatically populate the calendar with. I don't have to stick with those photos. I can add more. I can bring more in from other albums and other places and all of that. But it's good to have a starting point. So I'm in this Vacation album here, and I'm going to go to My Projects here in the left sidebar. Hit the plus button and then select Calendar. Now it's going to ask me a few questions first. First, how many months do I want? You could do 12 months, which makes sense, but you could also do 13, say, if you want people to be able to start using the calendar right away in December 2017. You can have that month there as well. You can do 14 months so they have an extra month going into 2019, that kind of thing. And then you set what the month is that it starts on. So I'm going to hit continue. And now I get to select a calendar type. And it gives you a short description here. Now if you really want to get creative and choose the perfect one, it's probably best that you try one and then you can easily delete that calendar and try another one and kind of get used to which ones are the ones that fit your style. So let's choose this one here called, it's just called Modern Lines, if there's a few of them called that. And I'm going to select it and click Create Calendar. And then it's going to create the calendar. And it's going to give me a warning here that it wasn't able to use all the photos because I didn't provide the exact number of photos I needed. Which is okay because I'll work on that. Now I've got all 13 months shown here and everything's filled in. At the bottom I've got a list of photos. And this is a list that shows all of the unused photos. So all the ones that it used it put in here, and all the ones it didn't use it stuck down at the bottom. I can switch to have it show the ones that it's used instead. I can also click the Add Photos button to add more to this list here at the bottom. And I can clear all the placed photos to start fresh. I can drag and drop from the bottom here to replace any photo here in any month very easily. So just do that. And so that way I can really quickly populate the calendar and get things looking the way I want. Also, I can double click on any month and go into it, and now I can have a little closer look at things, so I can drag and drop in there as well. I can also click Options here, and on the right I've got all these layout options, so I can choose from different layouts. So I can go anything from a just a single photo layout in this case, or even one that takes up the entire page there, to photos fitting four on a page, that kind of thing. So there's tons of layouts. These layouts depend on which style you've chosen. So there's some that actually have very few layout options and some that have a whole bunch like this one. So you can choose from this. I can hit the back button here. Other things I can do is I can rearrange the pages. So I can select this little bar here at the bottom and drag and drop to switch them. Now of course it's not going to switch the months. It's switching the layouts. So if I wanted these two pictures for instance to be after these, I can do that. And you can see it's still February and March. So I'm just switching what layouts are shown there. Now you have some other options as well. The different layout styles depend upon what you've chosen. So I can go for instance to the back cover here, and there's nothing you do with the back cover except that under options I can choose to go from blank to a single small photo. And again this depends on which calendar type you've chosen, and I can even change the color here, so I can make it a different color. And that's only available on the back cover. And then the front cover here has under options the color it's going to use as the background there, and I can choose from different styles here, but not as many as I can on the internal pages. So you have lots of different things you can do depending on what you're choosing. So you can also choose the color for the internal pages for the borders for this particular calendar. For others you can't. Now you get to choose a few other options here. If you look at the these buttons here, you've got this button here is another way to bring up the layout options. But you also have this button here. You can change the months in the calendar. You can change to show national holidays for certain country if you want. Show your birthdays from contacts, which could be kind of fun. Or to show specific calendars. So if you wanted specific dates on here, you could create a calendar in the Calendars app, choose it here, and then it would show up there. So you could put all sorts of things, anything you want really. You can create a work calendar. You can create a calendar of special family events. You can download and subscribe to calendars online, since calendars uses the standard format, and you know, bring in religious calendars, all sorts of things, and then select those calendars then to appear here. So you have complete control over what appears in the dates as well. You can select whether or not to use the Apple logo on the back, and you can also switch the theme to one of the other themes there. So I wouldn't do that while you're actually building a real calendar. I would do that while you're experimenting. For something like this, you want to experiment first, play around with it, get to know the tool, and then start fresh when you think you know everything you need to know to build the calendar you want, and build that calendar. And then you can click the Buy Calendar button. There's placeholder text that's still here. I can review and I can go continue and add a shipping address, add payment information if you don't already have that through iTunes, and place the order. Great thing is that you can order a bunch to yourself and give them as gifts, or you can actually order one and have it sent to the person you want to send a gift to. So it's a great little option, a lot of fun to play with. Another thing you could do if you want is to print this calendar. So selecting it here on the left in the sidebar, you can go File, Print, and you can print it out yourself if you have a really good printer at home, and put it together yourself, or at least preview it. You can also, of course, open it in preview or save as a PDF if you want to do that as well. So play around with the calendars function. Could be useful this holiday season.